Okay, so hello, my name is Marc Perelló, and I'm going to present my current work involving the integration of Undervolting to the OmpSs FPGA environment. Undervolting is an effective way to reduce total power consumption, but the process of undervolting is not only time-consuming, but also device-dependent. That's why the integration of undervolting procedures into an environment such as OmpSs FPGA can make undervolting more accessible, while also giving the opportunity to pair it with other features from the toolchain. So the main objective is to have device-specific information and undervolting procedures inside the runtime API. As a demonstration, we used the Xilinx GCU102 board and the N-body application developed by the OmpSs FPGA team. We undervolted two of the FPGA rails and we evaluated the power consumption reduction. Okay, so a brief explanation for this slide. VNOM means nominal voltage, which is the standard voltage the rails operate at by default. VMIN indicates the lowest voltage to not have any observable faults, and VCrash is the lowest voltage observed to not crash the application or the system. As you can see, we manage a 51% reduction in power consumption by lowering the voltage to VMIN, with no impact on performance. Okay, so now I'm going to do a brief showcase of the undervolting API on the same N-body application. Okay, so here we can see an example of the API usage. Nano's FPGA adjust voltage gradually reduces the voltage to the specified target. We first lower the voltage, and then we increase the voltage back to nominal when the FPGA task has been executed. First, we're going to execute the application without undervolting. We are also going to use a program which makes use of the API to monitor the voltage rails of the board. As we can see, the VCC int usage is around 12 to 14 watts when the application is executing. Now we are going to uncomment the lines to apply undervolting and see the change. Okay, so here we can see that the API is lowering the voltage to the specified target. The way we arrived to those VMIN voltage values was by gradually lowering the voltage until it gave the wrong output or started misbehaving. Okay, so as you can see, the power consumption of VCC int has lowered to around 7 watts, much lower than what it was before. Okay, so that was the demonstration of our work. Thank you for watching.